you talking about? Muhammad married a 9-year-old. Did he not? Did he not? And so what?
I know how to expose him.
And so what?
What did God say in the Old Testament?
Do you want me to prove?
In the Old Testament, God said he's the only Savior.
Do you want me to prove?
In the Old Testament, God said he's the only Savior.
The Quran calls Jesus Savior.
No. Listen.
The Quran calls Jesus Savior. And the Messiah, the Son of Mary. This is in the Quran. By definition, recognizing Jesus as the Messiah, you are calling him a Savior. I can go even further and tell you that it was Jesus on Mount Sinai that gave the Ten Commandments to Moses.
You need to repent, my brother.
I told him already, you need to repent.
You need to repent.
When? I said, when? The first man in Adam. Adam was a Muslim.
Where did Adam be a Muslim?
The sin of their life.
Where did Islam come into being? Where did Islam come into being?
Okay, at the time of how old is Islam?
How old is Islam?
Answer, how old is Islam?
You asking a question?
Answer! How old is Islam?
Why did I answer? I said Islam was there since the first human being.
Let me tell you, like your father.
I don't need to tell you because you are all the same. I thought I could reason with my fellow Africans.
What are you writing, Harry?
I thought I could reason with my.
What are you talking about?
But this man
doesn't want
to. You see, I love you as a brother, but you see that the truth, then you started shouting. Because I make you reason.
You're lying.
I make him reason to catch
you're
himself.
You're lying.
I asked him, my brother, I asked him, what was the religion? Lying. What was the religion of Abraham? And he told me, he told me, Abraham was a God worshipper.
But Muhammad
was God worshipper. I'm not talking to you now, my brother. I'm not talking to you now. And he said, Abraham was a God worshipper. One God he was worshipping, we all know. And I told him, and I already defined the meaning of Muslim. I said, who is a Muslim? A Muslim is somebody who worship one God. Abraham was a Muslim.
What is the name of your God?
Allah. That's his name.
Let me ask you something. Yeah. Is he the same God that told Muhammad to take 366 idols from the Kaaba?
Yes. He's the one who destroyed it, who made Muhammad
the Kaaba, where there was 366 idols.
That before the advent of Islam.
Asking you a question.
That temple. Yeah, it's still a temple for Satan worship. Yes.
The Kaaba was built to worship one God. Okay. When the pagan Arabs took it over, they turned it into idols. They put idols in there to worship. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to clear it and to reverse it back into worshiping one God. Because he doesn't want to be
the bottom line. They know better than you.
The bottom line is Muhammad.
They are from Saudi. They know better than you. What are you telling them?
So because he's from Saudi, you know they look as stupid.
Boy, what the heck you're telling them?
Muhammad came.
Speak to him. Speak to him.
Of idol worship.
Why are you telling the Saudis?
And so what?
He's a man.
Tell him. He's from Pakistan.
Okay, if you're from Saudi, so what? Who told you that Saudi man? You come here putting your camera on.
You can't touch, bro.
No, he's talking nonsense.
Why are you telling him? Speak to him. Speak to him.
Right now, so Muhammad comes on the scene, looks at a place of Satan worship. Hold on, 366 idols, says, clear it up. You clear it up. Yes, but this is now the same building.
Okay,
hold on, the same temple that when you pray, you face.
Do you know
till this day? where they were saying to worship.
You don't know. Where you don't know,
that's correct.
It's absolutely wrong.
How is it not correct?
Okay, let me tell you why.
What is the black stone?
Let me tell you why.
Okay, tell me what the black stone is.
You see the Kaaba? It was that the Kaaba, that same particular building you are talking about.
Yeah.
It was first built by Abraham.
No scientific archaeological.
You don't want
evidence.
To listen. What is evidence? The problem? I'm trying to
Where
tell you about
show
the,
your evidence.
The true source of the Kaaba. Now you are
show
using
your evidence. You don't make a claim.
Where's the evidence that Abraham
that
built
is Muslim.
It's a claim.
Where's the evidence?
Where's the evidence
that Abraham built it?
The Quran came 600 years after the Bible.
So
yeah. Where is the evidence?
The Torah came 400 years before the Bible.
You know where you have a problem?
Eh?
You know where you have a problem?
We don't have problem. You have problem. Your Bible is full of contradictions.
The Quran says that it is written to confirm the Torah and the books that existed before.
Yeah.
It mentioned the Torah and the Injil. The
Do
gospel,
you have the Torah
the
that
gospel.
Is the Quran
hold
is
on,
talking about?
Hold on.
You think when we tell the Torah
before
we are talking
we
about the books that you are holding, shaking or
before
even?
We can confirm your book?
You think this is
yes.
the Torah and the Injil?
You need,
this is not what the Quran
Muhammad
is talking
says,
about.
Go to the people of the book.
Listen,
to
you
that.
Are,
listen, Muhammad not say that.
Listen, no,
Muhammad
no,
not say that.
Muhammad never said that.
That's
you are lying. My friend, let me correct you. When the Quran said confirming the previous scripture.
Yes,
we are not
Quran,
talking about this.
No, it talks about
this
Quran.
Is Quran.
The Torah
this is
the Old
Bible.
Testament.
Do you know the meaning of Bible? The
Torah,
collection of books.
The Old
and you say it's Torah.
The Old Testament and the New Testament. The Old Testament
you don't know what
and the New Testament.
My friend, you don't know
and you're saying Abraham. Abraham built the Kaaba.
Yes.
No, absolutely.
Yes. You don't want to listen. That's why you come and start the history by cutting it. You know.
Speak to him.
The first house. The first house that was.
Look at him. Come right on to him.
That was built.
Talk to him.
Stop
to him.
The gospel of Jesus Christ.
Talk to him. Wait on
the
to him.
The gospel of Jesus Christ is one that every man should repent.
It's running.
Every man should
repent. Don't run. Speak to him.
And accept Jesus.
No, you won't.
You stupid man.
No, you won't.
Under
you will
I
not touch
have
him.
Rights. Section 29J of the Public Order Act. I can speak whatever I want in this park.
Why is this all full of violence?
You run away from me when you get me. I want to talk to any of my African Ukrainian guys. This is where you don't know about Islam.
Why is it
you want to get violent now? Why?
Why?
I don't mean that.
Yeah, but where is it?
Somewhere out of Spanish.
Why?
Because
he has a right.
He's Christian in this guy. Like you.
He's Christian. He has a right to say what he wants to say.
Section 29J.
As I was saying, that Islam is a lie from hell.
Muhammad
is a liar.
You are worshiping
Muhammad is a liar.
And you are all destined
and
to
Jesus
hell.
Christ is Lord and Savior.
Yeah, that's why you are all going to
So hell. I didn't stutter.
But Jesus was a liar.
Did I stutter?
Yes.
Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior.
He was a man.
He died for the whole of mankind.
God died. God
there
died.
Is no truth in
you
or your father.
God died.
Satan is your
God,
father.
God died.
Yeah, yeah.
God died. And you worship a man.
Me?
You worship man.
I
who was eating
worship
food?
The Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Died on the cross.
Amen.
And he calls all men to repent of their sins.
You think I'm a man
worshiping
man?
How
you
worship
a man?
You are blind.
Wait a minute,
man. My friend,
you are going to hell.
I'm telling you, you are going to hell. Because your Bible tells you that if you don't worship
Jesus,
the true God, you are going to hell.
Jesus,
and you are worshiping
you
man.
Are lost.
My friend, you are worshiping a man. And you
Muhammad
are destined
is in
for
hell right now,
you
burning.
Are, you are
the same man you're worshiping. He's a liar and a father of lies.
You are a big liar.
He's a liar and a father of lies. And he's deceiving millions. I'm saying it.
Big
Jesus Christ is Lord.
You are a big
You are lost.
You are worshiping a man. You are best in hell.
Right now,
you are the same man you're worshiping.
He's a liar and a father of lies.
You are a big liar.
Muhammad is a liar and a father of lies, and he's deceiving millions. I'm saying it. Jesus Christ is Lord.
You are a big liar.
No apologies. I'm not afraid of any of you.
You are a man worshiper.
I will speak the truth.
You worship a man who eats food, and that's why you are destined for the hellfire. I'm telling you.
Let's see. Let's see.
I will.
No apologies.
I will never worship
No apologies.
Woman, worship
just like
I
Elijah, I will preach
Jesus,
the gospel that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord.
God give me this intellectual reason.
He is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
I'll never waste my time.
Repent
me that,
of
God,
your sin.
You said God,
repent
God
and
God
accept
died.
Jesus
you
as
said,
your
Jesus
Savior. Don't point your
Jesus
finger at my
God.
Face.
My friend, Jesus is God.
Back down.
No, I'm not. You back down.
Yeah,
you
back down.
I'm not
I am not fretting.
by you or anybody here.
I said, you,
believe me.
Listen, we are not fighting. We are
I didn't stutter. Okay. So I made it very clearly.
I said, listen, you said Jesus was a God, isn't it?
What does the Quran call Jesus?
Jesus is a prophet. Prophet of God.
The Quran doesn't call him prophet.
Then you don't know what
the Quran calls him, the Messiah.
Messiah, well, yeah.
Right.
Yeah, you said Messiah.
Good. What does Messiah mean?
Messiah means the anointed one.
Nope.
That's what it means. Yes.
The definite. Let me speak.
Listen,
the definition of a Messiah is someone who has come to save a nation.
You are lying, my friend. You are lying.
Someone who has come to save a nation. Your own book calls Jesus a savior.
No, you
call him Messiah.
The Quran. The
you
Quran,
call him Messiah. You don't call him prophet.
Of God.
No, you call him Messiah.
Of God.
Messiah is higher than a prophet.
Of God. Okay. Prophet of God. That's what the Quran called Jesus.
It's a book of contradictions.
Your Bible.
Your Quran. Your Quran.
Bible. Can you?
Your Quran came 600 years after the Bible.
Came 400 years after the Quran.
Hold on. Muhammad says, "Go to the people of the book, the Jews, to learn."
You are lying.
Muhammad instructs you. Go to the people of the book. The Quran says it is written to confirm the Old Testament and the New Testament. Confirm. In other words, your book cannot stand without its confirmation of the Torah.
Confirming the previous book, you think this is what he's talking about?
Clearly.
He's not talking about this.
Old Testament and the Injils. And the Injils. What's the Injils?
What's the meaning of Bible? What's the meaning of Bible?
Okay, you are lost.
Holy. What is the meaning of it?
If you are expecting me to kneel down and pray and face the Quran, you're expecting me to kneel down and face the Kaaba where there is a black stone. What is the black stone?
With black stone.
What is the black stone? 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 What has I got to do? What is the black stone? 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 Answer the question. What is the black stone? What is the black stone? What is the black stone, brother?
Brother, to teach you the Bible.
What is the black stone?
I know you haven't read your Bible.
What is the black stone? What is the black stone? What is the black stone?
Do you want to talk about?
What is the black stone? What is the black stone? What is the black stone got to do with worship? Answer the question.
You are digressing.
Answer the question.
You are talking about.
Answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question.
When you come to the oneness of God.
Answer the question.
The sweat. I'll come to that.
You bow to a building that has 966 idols. That was the home of idol worship. You bow to that when you pray. You touch a black stone in Mecca.
When he finishes the talk,
you walk around it.
I keep quiet.
And you worship it.
This guy is just shouting like he doesn't even go to anything.
These guys are a bunch of liars.
Come and talk, man.
Absolute liars. Idol worships. Leave him alone. Don't intimidate him. Idol worshippers is what you are. What are we talking about? Muhammad what? Muhammad married a 9-year-old. Did he not? And so what?
I know how to expose him.
And so what? Muhammad married a 9-year-old, and you're saying, and so what?
Is he
your prophet? Is he a prophet? Are you telling me to believe in a man who married a 9-year-old as a prophet of God?
You want me to worship him, man?
Let me bring you back to the Bible. Wait a minute.
He's not going to let you go.
Does it make sense?
Give me 2 minutes. Can we talk?
Every time we come against Islam, there's always a spirit of violence.
I know he doesn't read the Bible.
Why is there a spirit of violence? Why does the Quran instruct you to behead and kill the life of infidels, people who don't believe, people who don't believe in Islam? It instructs you to kill infidels. How is that a religion of love? Where is the love in your God? Where is the love in your God? I challenge you. Where is the love in your God?
Let's debate. I'll expose you.
Where is the love in your God?
I'll expose it.
Why?
I can't. I'm going to tell you from the Bible. Let's debate.
When you don't believe what they believe, they want to kill, they want to stab, they want to destroy, they want to blow people up. Why? Why? I want you to know that I am not afraid of you guys. Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior, and he calls all men to repent and accept him as Lord and Savior. That is the gospel of Jesus. He loves all men, but calls all men to repentance that they may live.
There is no Savior.
You follow this man, you follow his shortness to hell. You follow this man, you go straight to hell. You follow Muhammad, you go to hell. Muhammad never died for you. His blood was never shed for you. Without the blood of Jesus Christ, you are lost.
Wait, the Bible. He doesn't know. They've got nothing, man.
Debate what? I'm here. There's nothing to debate.
Look.
He wants to debate. Let's look at a few. Let's look at a few facts.
Earlier on, you were confident. You are talking to.
Let's look at a few facts.
Look at the man. You attack. The Muslim, you say back is about Rasul. Let's debate. Yes, if you have got bigger brain as your boss.
My gosh.
I'm a small man. Yes. I expose you.
So, as we read from the Quran, I ask this man, what is the black stone that is attached to the Kaaba in Mecca that you bow to and worship? A black stone. This is the justification for bowing to a black stone in Mecca. I heard Abbas say, the messenger of Allah says, the stone will be brought on the day of resurrection and it will be given to eyes with which to see and a tongue which to speak.
Look, you guys always worship
Buddha. It endorses idol worship, idolatry, liars. When Jesus died on the cross for all of mankind, that all who repent shall be saved.
Because it's empty.
You're a coward.
I'm not a coward. I'm not going to believe a prophet.
You know why a coward?
Debate what?
Debate what? Jesus the God.
There's nothing to debate.
Jesus the God.
You've got nothing.
No, thank you.
You have nothing. Calm down.
Embarrassed what? Jesus not God.
You know why I'm laughing?
No, look at me.
You know why I'm laughing?
Look at me, you're laughing, you're embarrassed.
Because it's full of lies.
Let's debate them.
Then expose them.
They expose me.
I don't need to expose. I've already exposed. He's got nothing. He's got nothing.
Let's debate it. Let's prove it.
I'm not here to debate. I'm here to preach the gospel.
Look at this.
There is a difference.
Look at this, my
brother. I'm here to preach the gospel. There's a big difference.
Yes, I was talking to a brother.
Because it's a lie.
Then Jesus is the God.
Choose a topic.
Then the Quran confirms it.
It's a lie.
When I came here, see the debate. One is a God. Let's talk about God.
This man is a coward.
No, he has been there. Tawheed. Who is God?
God bless you. God bless you. God bless all Muslims. But you need to repent.
Okay, let's debate. One is a God. We believe Jesus is not God.
What are you ranting about? What is your problem? Relax. What is your problem? Why are you ranting?
You want to debate about your Bible.
You see,
Lami came here, you know your Bible very well. And you would have been
I know the spirit of Islam. That is absolutely. 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 I don't come to debate. Exactly.
You don't have to debate now.
I have come to preach the gospel.
You are debating him.
You are debating him.
Jesus Christ.
You are debating him.
You are lying. You see,
Jesus Christ.
You are debating with me.
Because now you are debating him. But I disagree with him.
No, but why are you scared of me?
You don't want to
debate. How can I be scared of you?
Intellectual, I just want you as a liar.
I'm here.
As a liar, my friend.
God bless you. God bless you.
Because Jesus is not God.
God bless you.
Jesus was a man.
God bless you.
Jesus God.
Yes, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Okay.
He doesn't know. John 17:3.
Do you want to hear? Will you listen?
He doesn't know.
Are you going to listen?
I'm listening now.
Jesus was a man. Are you a man?
If you start ranting, I'll stop talking.
Look, that's what I want. I'll give you five.
If you start ranting.
I'll give you five.
You said, is Jesus Christ God? Yes. Is that what you want to answer?
Yes. God.
Right.
I want you to go for
all right, let me finish. Let me finish. Silence. Okay, silence. Now, before we deal with the divinity of Jesus Christ, we need to get some facts in place. Let me finish. Understand that I cannot refer to a book that was written 600 years after the Bible to check whether Jesus is God or not. Secondly, I cannot refer to a book that says it confirms the Torah, the Old Testament, and the Injils as the book to refer to for truth. Now, I will now go to the Bible and make it very clear. In the Torah, it makes very clear, Isaiah 9:6, unto us a book that you are obligated to believe in. Yes? Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given, and his name shall be Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. This is 600 years before the Quran came into being. Jesus himself was almost stoned to death because when he spoke to the Pharisees, they asked him, what is your name? And Jesus says, I am that I am. At hearing that, they picked up stones to stone him. And the Bible says, Jesus asked, why are you trying to stone me? And the Pharisee says, because you, being a man, equal yourself to God. I cannot. It is very clear in the Bible that Jesus Christ is God. In the book of John, the Injils that your Quran asks you to follow, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Verse 14 of that same chapter says, and the Word put on flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus was fully God and fully man. I am not here to debate. I am here to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ.
All the verses you quote, I'll debunk them. Let me debunk them. Listen to me now. Let me give you Bible lessons.
Bible lessons.
Yeah, listen. You're going to listen now.
No, listen. Teach me. Teach me.
Listen.
Yeah, I'll listen.
That's good, man.
You've got to keep your word. Come on.
Big younger brother. No, older than you.
Go on.
Let me tell you something.
Go on.
You see, only people come here.
Yeah.
You quote the Bible. Why do you study the Bible? In the Bible, there's not a single verse in the Bible. Let me mark on that. Single verse in the Bible.
Divinity. Stick to the topic. Stick to the topic.
Jesus said, what's it be?
Yeah. Stick to the topic.
If you read the Bible, Jesus himself said, Gospel of John, chapter 17, verse number 3. John 73.
Yeah.
Christians don't like, they don't like hearing, they don't like it.
Go on, go on.
He said, and this is eternal life. This is eternal life, that they might know that you are the only true God.
Okay.
The only true God,
all right,
and Jesus Christ whom I have sent.
Okay.
This is explicit.
Should I address? Should I address that statement you just made? I'm not running.
Let me finish first.
Okay. If you're gonna quote, and then you question
you
I've got to answer.
No. You quote John
1. In what you said.
You quote John 1:1. I know.
Yeah.
I didn't answer. I let you speak. You quote Isaiah 9:6.
Yeah.
And you quoted.
You're quoting 73.
I am who I
okay,
am,
go on.
Which is Gospel of Mark. You
yeah.
quote that.
Yeah.
14.
Yeah.
Quote. I know all that.
Yeah.
I didn't address them. Let me finish. Then you can. I'll address
There's
them.
A lot
let
of
me
okay.
quote first.
Okay.
Jesus, what Jesus said.
If the Quran confirmed the Bible. When the Quran talking about the free people.
Okay. Wait. Let's take. So let me quote first the oneness of God. What Jesus is on was. Jesus said in the Gospel of God again.
Yeah.
I quoted that John 17:3. Jesus said, "Father is the only true God. Only."
Yes. I finished.
That's a penalty. Let me call again.
No, I finished.
No, I'm not finished. Let me call.
Go on.
Gospel of John, chapter number 8, verse number 40. Jesus said to his enemies, but now you seek to kill me. A man who has told you the truth, which I have from God, a distinction. Furthermore, in the Bible.
Show me in the Bible. What verse? Let's look at it in context.
Show me the verse in the Bible. Listen to me.
Let's read the context.
Okay, wait.
We want context.
Okay, wait. I will read it. Wait.
No, wait.
No, wait. No, let's
read the verse in context. We want context.
As I 9:6, Gospel of Mark. I didn't interrupt.
Give us the context now. All right, go on. Give us. Quote the Bible.
Wait, it's not true.
You've got an angry spirit in you. You've got an angry spirit in you. No, you've got a violent spirit in you. You have a violent spirit in you.
Look, I gave you time.
Go on.
I didn't interrupt you.
Show me the verse. Let's look at it in context.
John 1:1.
I'm not.
I didn't put the context.
He's quoting something. I want to see the context.
But I didn't interrupt you.
I'm not interrupting you. I'm saying show me the verse.
I didn't.
Show me the verse.
I didn't say as I now say put the context. I didn't say that.
I can do it. I'm not afraid.
I didn't do. I wait for you. Okay. John, go.
Let's go, brother.
John 8:40. Then. I should have done it to you, but I'm just quoting you. Stop me. That means I haven't read your Bible. John 8:40. John 7:3. You know that.
Which one are we going to? Which one are we going to?
One by one now. Run it to court.
Which one?
John 73.
And when you quote it, let's look at the context.
Digressing.
You've got nothing to offer. You've got nothing.
I know.
You make a lot of comments. I want you to.
But I know how to deal with them. You leave it to them. John 73. Put that in the context to me.
Right. Okay. Quote it again.
John 73.
Yeah, go and quote it. Quote it.
And this is eternal life.
Yes.
Then I know.
Yes.
That you are the only true God.
Yes.
And Jesus Christ, whom we have sent.
Yes. Right.
Okay. Put that in
okay.
One by one.
Right. Very simple. Very simple. Jesus prayed. It's the same thing. Jesus prayed, and we would listen, and we would come to know Him and His Father. Yes. And this is the life eternal, that they may know Thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom Thou hast sent.
Let
me finish. You made a statement. You take it out of context. Let me explain this. Yes? Don't interrupt me. Okay. Now, very simple. It is very easy, and I'm going to explain it. I'm not running away. To take one text, isolate it, and take it out of context. And that's exactly what you've done. Right. When you are looking, let me finish. Can I finish? Can I finish? Baba, listen. Listen. Okay, right. Now, the Bible has to be read in context. Let me finish. Don't interrupt me. Every chapter backs up every chapter. There is a context to everything that is said. Now, when he said, when you take the book of John, yes, the same John that you are quoting from, John 17:3, if you go to the first chapter, it clearly defines the relationship between Jesus and the Father. Let me finish. Yes. It defines, let me finish. Unto us, sorry, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was equal to God. And in verse 14, the Bible says, that same chapter says, and the Word put on flesh and dwelt among us. Let me finish. No, let me finish. No, I'm finished. I haven't finished. I haven't made my point. When Jesus was on this earth, he was fully God and fully man. He existed as fully God and fully man. But there were times that it was essential that he expressed himself through his divinity. And there were times that it was essential that he expressed himself through his humanity. It depended on the context. Now, bearing that in mind, bearing that in mind,
no, you're taking my time.
What he has said here,
let me put the context.
I'm finishing now. Hold on. I'm finishing. Jesus prayed. Jesus prayed that we would come to know him and his Father. Hold on. And this is the eternal. This is life eternal. You're not even listening. You're not even listening. And this is the verse that he quoted. And this is life eternal. And this is life eternal, that they may know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. In other words, Jesus is praying.
Okay, let me finish.
His humanity is praying to express worship to the Father so that we can learn from what he's doing. It's a simple expression. It's very simple.
Okay, I'm talking now. Please give me time. Now I'm going to debunk you. And give me time.
Go ahead.
Yeah, give me that. You saying that we quote the Bible out of context.
You have?
Listen.
You have?
John 17:3, where Jesus said he's the only true God.
You're calling Jesus a man.
You said Jesus is fully God, fully man.
Fully God and fully man.
There is not a single verse in the Bible. Listen to me. Let me finish. I'll deal with him. There's not a single verse in the Bible where it says that Jesus is fully God, fully man.
John chapter 1.
It's a lie.
1 to 14.
John 1:1. Let me
1 to 14.
I'll put John 1 into
14. 1 to 14.
Let me quote it. I'll quote it.
No, we'll read it together.
No, don't read it together. Let me read it. I know in my heart.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
John 1:1.
The whole chapter.
The most famous verse, one of in the Bible. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
Who is the
verse
Word?
Verse 2 said,
and he.
He.
Right. So the Word is he.
He. Let me talk.
The Word is he.
The Word was with God.
And he created all things.
Let him dig himself.
Thank you.
And John 14 says, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. So according to them, this is Jesus, God incarnate. Now, the question is now. In the beginning was the Word. That Word in the beginning.
It was with someone.
Now, was that Word in the beginning God or not?
Okay.
The Word in the beginning. Was it God or not? That's the question.
I'll answer the question.
It's either yes
or
no.
I'll answer the question.
The Word in the beginning is God.
It's very simple.
The Word in the beginning is God. It goes against what God himself says in the Old Testament.
No, it doesn't.
In the book of Deuteronomy.
Where it says.
The Bible. Let me quote.
Go on.
Let me quote.
Go on.
If the Word in the beginning, you said, is God.
Yes.
The Word in the beginning is God.
Yes, I can prove it.
It goes against, listen to me, what God himself said in the Old Testament. It means that John forgot to read the Old Testament. Because in the book of Deuteronomy,
yes,
chapter number 32,
yeah,
verse number 39,
yes,
God himself said,
yes,
see now that I am he.
Yes.
There is no God with me.
Okay.
I kill and I make alive.
All right.
I wound and I heal.
All right, let me answer.
Neither is there any.
Let me answer.
I will finish.
Go on, finish.
So, God is telling you there is no God with him in the beginning. So, if Jesus was God, if John, what John said, and they believe that, that John means that the Word in the beginning was God, it goes against what was in the Old Testament.
Okay. So, let me explain it then.
I'm finished.
All right.
Let me finish. And when you go to verse number 2, verse number 2 said, the word that Jesus was with God. Who was with God in the beginning? He never said verse number two.
All
John
right.
1:2.
Okay.
Let me finish. God was with God. He said, he, the word, that is Jesus, was with God.
Okay. All right. Let's look at this.
Emphatic. Jesus was with God.
Let's deal with it.
Let me finish. Let me go to 3. And if you read this Bible, you see, the.
Stick to the context. Stick to the words.
The God or Greek word, yeah, the translated words used is theos and theon. Theos, when you hear theos, theos is a general Greek word,
yeah,
which means God. General,
yeah,
Greek word,
yeah,
for God.
Yeah.
Theon means Almighty God, the Creator.
Okay.
So it means in the beginning was theos, the word, and that theos was with theon,
okay,
Almighty God, the Creator.
All right, let's put this to bed. It's very simple. John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Very simple. Equal to was God.
No,
let me finish. Let me finish.
Equal to.
Let me finish.
Don't say equal.
Let me finish. And I'll prove it. Let me finish. The same was in the beginning with God. Now, the power to create is divine. Yes, all things were made by Him, and without Him, not anything was made. The power to create is a divine attribute. And the Word, who is defined as a He, created all things. And the word that is being talked about is equal to God because he has the power to create. Who does Allah have the power to create?
You know what?
Yes.
No, listen to me.
Yes.
God said it's only God.
You see how this guy's
no,
a liar?
No, you're lying.
You see how this guy's a liar?
Let me quote.
The book of Genesis says, let us make man. Let us make man.
I can put the context in our image. Let me put the context.
In our image.
Let me put the context.
Very simple.
No.
Let us.
What does that mean?
I can go even further.
What does that mean?
And tell you that it was Jesus on Mount Sinai that gave the Ten Commandments to Moses. Because he's the mediator for humanity. I can prove that to you.
Listen.
Before Abraham was I am.
Listen.
He was on. He was on the mountain. He's the one who gave commandments to Moses because he's the mediator. Are you? Do you want me to say it?
No, it's not there.
Do you want me to prove it?
Prove it.
Do you want me to prove it? You gotta listen. Are you going to listen?
Give me 2 minutes.
I am not a wishy-washy Christian.
Give me 2 minutes.
When I say something, I can back it up in context from the word.
In the Old Testament.
That's why a lot of Muslims can't handle me.
In the Old Testament.
You can't handle. It's not about being good. It's about Jesus being glorified. It's not about me scoring points.
Wait.
It's about lifting the name of Jesus.
Wait.
A big difference.
No, see.
I'm not here to push my PR.
What did God say in the Old Testament?
Do you want me to prove?
In the Old Testament, God said he's the only Savior.
Do you want me to prove?
In the Old Testament, God said he's the only Savior.
The Quran calls Jesus Savior.
No. Listen. You know, listen.
The Quran calls Jesus Savior.
Where?
Messiah. What does Messiah mean? What does Messiah mean? Answer the question. Answer the question. In the Quran, does the Quran call Jesus the Messiah?
In the Old Testament.
Answer the question.
In the book of Isaiah.
Does the Quran call Jesus Messiah?
Number 10 to 11. God said, before me, no God was.
Does the Quran call Jesus the Messiah?
After me, I am the Lord. And beside.
Does he call Jesus the Messiah? The Quran. Yes.
He's lying.
Messiah, by definition, says a savior is defined by a savior, someone who has come to save a nation. That's what Messiah means. Your own Quran is calling Jesus Savior. Not that I need the Quran to endorse the truth.
John 1:1.
Contradiction of lies. Do you want me to prove that Jesus was the one who gave Moses the Ten Commandments? Do you want me to prove that?
You can't prove in the Bible. You can't.
Are you?
Let me quote.
Yes, I can.
You cannot.
I will show you the scriptures.
You don't even know what God said in the Bible.
I will show you the scriptures.
You know, in the Old Testament.
Are you ready for me to show you the scriptures?
You know, in the Old Testament.
I will prove it to you.
In the Old Testament. Quote me 3 verses.
Both.
Where God is talking.
Both.
No. In the Old Testament.
I will show you in the New Testament.
Okay.
I will bring the Old Testament.
Okay. God,
and I will prove it to you that the Ten Commandments was given by the hand of, ordained by angels, but given by the hand of a mediator,
okay.
Jesus Christ.
Okay. Let me, okay, you
do that. The Ten Commandments was written, handwritten by Jesus' finger.
You're a liar. You see, you're coming. My neighbor is going to laugh at you.
I can prove it.
The
Bible is clear.
Listen to me.
Right, good.
He's God.
Do you want me to show you? I'll start. Let me build the picture from the scripture. I'll prove it.
Look,
he's not ready to listen.
No, let me.
I am.
No,
okay, we can have the conversation.
Let's have
the conversation.
You can go there if you want. Let me finish that.
Can I have the conversation with him?
Peter himself said, when Jesus left his.
Are you ready to listen to the conversation?
He wants to die as well. He's running.
I'm running from what?
He's running.
It's not about. Scoring points.
No, you don't know the Bible. I know you're quoting out of context. If you read the Bible, Peter himself.
You're ranting and you're raving.
You've been ranting already for 1 hour.
That's all you're doing.
You're not quoting anything.
You're not making any solid points.
I'm quoting.
He knows the Bible more than you.
Look, he doesn't know.
This man is deceived.
Peter, when Jesus left this world. Peter went to the
He's
cloud.
He's deceived, brother.
Peter was addressing
He's completely
the cloud
deceived.
After Jesus left this
He's
world.
He's lost.
With the what? With the disciples said.
He doesn't know the Bible.
All men of
Look,
Israel.
Let me tell you something. Anybody can read the Bible. But if the Holy Spirit, I do. If the Holy Spirit doesn't give you insight to what the Bible means, you are lost. There's so many false prophets that are using the Bible for nonsense. But if the Holy Spirit is not the teacher of what the Bible is saying, then you'll get deceived. And that's what happens to this guy. Absolutely. By faith in Christ and what he did on the cross. Absolutely. I believe Jesus died for my sins. I believe his blood was shed. I believe that he rose on the third day. I believe that you, brother, will stand before Jesus and he will play this scene before you. And he'll say, why didn't you accept my truth?
You know what? Old Testament. In the book of Exodus 20:33-5. You know,
bruv, what is your point?
Let me read it. You don't know.
It's a lot of ranting.
You don't know, that's why. You've been ranting.
It's a lot of ranting. What is your point?
Let me quote it.
What are you quoting? We were dealing with the divinity.
That's the same thing. They did the same thing.
We were dealing with the divinity of God.
I'm dealing with it. God said in the book of Exodus, chapter 22-5, God is talking. You people don't do that. He said, you shall have no other gods besides me.
Yes.
You shall not make for yourself a graven image.
Yes.
Or any likeness of anything.
Yes.
That is in heaven above. Yes. That is in earth beneath.
Who's making a graven image? Am I making a graven image?
But God said, you shall have.
I don't have a graven image.
You said Jesus is God.
Yes, he is.
What did this verse say? What did this verse say?
John chapter 1.
No.
John chapter 1, verse 1. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God.
No.
And the Word created everything. And the Word became flesh.
No.
What do you want me to say?
Isaiah 20:5.
I have answered with Scripture.
Isaiah 9:6.
Unto us a child is born. Unto us a son is given. And his name shall be Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. I'm giving you Scripture. No, I'm not. It's very clear. Alright, in the Quran.
I asked this man, I said,
does the Quran call Jesus a prophet or the Messiah?
And the Quran calls Jesus
yes?
the Messiah.
They have taken their scholars and monks as lords besides Allah. Yes? And the Messiah, the son of Mary. This is in the Quran. By definition, recognizing Jesus as the Messiah, you are calling him a savior. So I therefore ask you, one, he's not referred to as a prophet. He's called a savior. What is Jesus saving you from? You are confirming that Jesus died and he rose to save the whole of mankind. That's what Messiah means.
You're a liar.
In his Quran.
You're a liar. I tell you why.
In your Quran.
Messiah means anointed.
He doesn't know.
He's not a prophet. He's not God.
You call him Messiah. You call him Messiah. Even Muhammad said, go to the people of the book.
Let me explain it.
Those are the Jews. And the book in question is the Torah. The Old Testament. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! Jesus is Lord! Jesus is Lord! We give you glory! We give you honor, Lord! We lift you up as our Lord and Savior! Thank you, Jesus! Amen!
If you read the Old Testament,
we agree!
No, you can't! It's a lie!
Jesus is the Messiah!
What does that say?
He is my Savior!
You say you can back up everything you say.
He can't
back
up the Messiah means Savior. He doesn't know!
Very simple.
Show us the meaning of Messiah means Savior.
Sorry, let's. Let us define the word Messiah. Don't say anything. I didn't come here to rant and rave. Hallelujah.
John 1:1
was anointed one.
Revelation,
the one
Revelation.
There were many kings who were messiahs in the Bible.
Revelation 20,
no,
13.
That's not the context.
Ready to put them in the
that
context.
Is not the context. Don't change the context.
The man is disingenuous.
All right. Hold on.
God said something.
Hold on.
Chapter number 35.
Hold on. What does Messiah mean? Let me read it. Messiah.
The dictionary.
Translated. Yes.
The dictionary.
Let me speak. The promise. Let me finish. Let me finish. Can I finish? Can I finish? Can I finish? Can I read the definition of Messiah? Let me finish. Can I read? Relax. Calm down, brother. Calm down, brother. Right. Can I read the definition of Messiah? Hold on. This is the same word, the same title the Quran gives Jesus. Messiah, what does it mean? The promised deliverer of the Jewish nation.
Of what?
A leader regarded
hold on. Just the Jews.
A leader regarded as the savior of a particular country.
Yes.
Group or cause.
Yes.
I'll read again.
The
a leader regarded as the savior of a particular country. Yes, a group or cause. So, therefore, I ask you,
are you a Jew?
Therefore,
in the Bible,
are you a Jew?
Therefore,
I am a Jew.
Therefore,
if you recognize that Jesus is the Messiah, are you a Jew?
You recognize him as the savior,
are you a Jew? Not for you,
as a deliverer.
No, no. Do not you.
Why don't you recognize him as your savior?
Read it again.
Muslims go around and say he's a prophet. He's a prophet. In the Quran, it calls him Messiah, savior. A contradiction of lies.
You led yourself to the Jews. You were sent to the Jews.
Brother.
You were sent to the Jews. Read it again. He was sent to
you. Let me tell you something.
Jesus said, I was sent
Islam,
only. I was sent
Islam
only
is
to the
a lie.
Of the house of Israel, you see, you lied.
Islam is a lie. It's a lie. It's a lie.
You caught yourself there. Jesus was sent to you.
There is only one way to the kingdom of heaven.
Are you a Jew?
There is only one person by which humanity can be saved, including myself, a sinner saved by the grace of God. It is Jesus who died, divinity put on humanity. And when he went on that cross, his blood was shed that any man who repents shall be saved. One day you will die. You will stand before God. You will give an account. And the only defense that you will have for your sin is Jesus and his blood. So I urge you, repent of your sin and accept Jesus as your savior. He has paid the price. Hallelujah. Stay away from Islam. Stay away from liars. Stay away from idol worshippers. Stay away from people. You serve Islam, your soul will go to hell.
If you confess with your mouth. What did Jesus said?
Woo!
God said,
Hallelujah!
Holy Savior.
Hallelujah!
Jesus is Lord.
We can see he's a liar. He's not reading the Bible. Almighty God in the Old Testament said he's the only Savior. He doesn't read that.
Do you need an audience? If you need an audience, I can read.
Chapter number 43, 10 to
11. Isaiah 96.
Call me, no God will call me.
Take the stage.
No, stand there.
Take the stage. Take the stage, bro.
You don't read the Bible. You read the Bible in the book of Exodus. Chapter number 20, 3 to 4.
When is prayer? When is prayer? When is prayer? You need to go and pray.
Graven image or any likeness of anything.
What do you mean graven image? You bow. You bow to Kaaba in Mecca. You bow to a square building. There were 366 idols there. The black stone. You kissed the black stone.
In the Bible.
You're the idolater.
In the Gospel of Matthew.
You bow down to a black stone in Mecca.
Chapter number 4, verse number 10.
Hypocrite.
Worship the Lord your God as only him.
Talking about idolatry. So why are you bowing to Mecca?
Said, worship the Lord your
why are you buying to Mecca? Why are you buying to the Kaaba?
In the Gospel of God.
Why are you buying to the Kaaba?
In the Bible, Gospel of God, chapter 4, verse number 20, it says that the hour is coming, and now is when the true worshippers, when the true worshippers, will worship the Father.
Jesus Christ is
in
Lord.
Spirit and the truth. For the Father,
you, you're an idol worshipper.
According to Jesus,
you are an idol worshipper.
What did Jesus say?
You are going to bow to the Kaaba.
Are you a true worshipper?
366 idols in the Kaaba. The black stone. All of that. You're idolatry.
John 17:3.
You're a liar.
Yeah. This is eternal life. You are the only true God. What does that mean? The only true God.
I've got another one.
You don't know.
What does Allah say? What does Allah refer to himself as we?
Look, look, I'll tell you why.
What,
sorry. I'll tell you why. Listen.
Why does Allah refer to himself as we?
Listen to me. He quoted.
If he's one true God, why does Allah refer to him as we? Is that not plural? Is that plural?
Allah 9:6. Revelation.
Why does Allah say we?
13.
We.
All of them.
Where?
But he wouldn't give you time.
Where are we?
He's quoting out of context.
We.
I'll tell you why we.
We.
I'll tell you.
We.
Let me tell you.
We.
Let me tell you. Let me tell you.
Is that Allah's?
Let me tell you.
Plural.
People don't even know your Bible.
Yeah, whatever.
You quote Genesis.
I said in your Quran.
Let me tell you. You quote Genesis 1:26. All the verses you quote. Listen to me. Also, prepare.
Bruv,
let me talk to debunk them.
I don't need to go to a book
you
that is 600 years after the Bible.
Your Bible.
I don't need to a book that was written 600 years after the Bible.
The Bible against you.
I don't need to do that.
No. We don't. It's your Bible.
I don't need to endorse the truth.
I said your Bible.
You got nothing to offer.
I said your Bible.
You got nothing to offer.
You don't even know.
That's it.
When I said, what does God say about himself?
You don't God bless you. God bless you.
What does God say about himself?
God bless you.
In the Bible,
God says God bless.
His oneness. You see?
God bless you.
God bless you. God in the
God bless
Bible.
You. God, Hallelujah!
Yeah. See, so come on.
He knows. He said, cut. Yeah.
Oh, you know, man.
Come on. Let me finish. So in the Bible,
that's the fruits of love.